Alright! Hello everybody, it is I, Granorite, and here we are back with another episode of Let's Play Pokemon Emerald with our Gen 3 type challenge of Ground type. At the end of our last episode, we took on the Moss Deep City Gym. Congratulations to us. And we are now going to go liberate the Space Center. First things. Then we're going to just keep leveling up our pokes, making our way towards the Cetopolis gym next, our final gym. Hope everybody is doing well. We should be seeing our final evolution either this episode or next episode. We'll have to see just how far we get in this episode. Our next level target is 46. So, yeah, I think it's 46. Yes. And we'll get our last evolution here at 45. So the big question is how much issue, how much of an issue are we going to have against Juan and then subsequently Wallace with this team? This is a better team to deal with water than our last one. But we'll just have to see. Dum-dum-dum. We missed the muddy water. The sandstorm's not going to do anything to us because we are also ground type. Right, let's swap up Nidoqueen. This should level up Nidoqueen. Yeah. Good deal. We'll go to Swampert for the Numble here. We'll go to Vibrava for the Mighty Anna. Good job, Vibrava. Mm-hmm. when we get this triple fight. This should give Vibrava up to 43 by the end of these three fights. Excellent. Let's secret power. Okay. Now we get to choose our team for this fight, but that's okay. Alright, we're going to start off with Swampert, and then we'll also put in Gligar, because Gligar needs to level up, and then I think we'll go Nidoqueen for our final. Let's muddy water if we can. Okay, he swaggers the Metang, so that's good for us. Gonna hit itself. Good start. Camerupt is gonna drop like a stone. Alright, well, there's the other Mighty Yetta. Alright, now Swampert gets swaggered. The other Mighty Yetta down. And they really don't like this Metang. Come on, Swampert. Good deal. Good critical hit on Crobat. Any accuracy drops? No. Let's just do another Muddy Water. Oh, that Metang is going nowhere.
You're going nowhere. I got you for 3 minutes. 3 minutes.
Goodbye, Crobat. And there's the other camera up, just in time for a muddy water, assuming we get past the confusion. Ah, Swampert, look at you. Drops like a rock. Oh, and the Mighty Enna avoided the attack. So let's... single target Ice Beam. Just in case it goes down to this Metal Claw, the Ice Beam is ready for the Golbat that's going to follow up. Didn't quite take it down. Got close. She's getting confused. And the Metang. Poor Metang. See me. Ooh, that's not what I want to do. Of course, we do need to get the fishing pole from here, don't we? Just in case we need to go fishing. Alright, now we're gonna go north of town and take on the trainers up there. And our Pokemon that still needs to level up is Gligar to 43, so we're gonna swap Gligar up. Because Gligar Man! I don't know if you remember that amazing episode of Pokemon with Gligar Man. I don't think that song was in it though. It was more of a Batman like Gligar Man! Alright! Slash. And then we will Aerial Ace. Close, Gligar. He heard me approaching. Wow. That's a little impressive. We'll slash this. That's a cool. That's gonna do nothing. Oh, almost got it. If I would have done two Aerial Aces, we would have took it down. The Bubble Beam did a little bit more damage than the Acid did. Let's ancient power there and muddy water. Aw, stat boost across the board for Claydol. Claydol's ancient power all the way up. Vibrava. You with the seeking. Two more levels. Oh. Well, at least I tried a supersonic. Good deal. So fast! And then it uses water gun. Does a bit of damage. Let's swap up Nidoqueen. We can do this double battle with Vibrava. Sludge bomb? Good damage, Nidoqueen. Burn us. We got the flinch on the Manectric from the King's Rock. Just Sludge Bomb again on that Zatu.
Expert Aura.
Alright. Good body slam. Got a big pearl. We're gonna hop over here. I'm gonna swap back up Swampert. Should be the final trainer on this route. We're gonna mud shot it. Steep and we'll heal up. And let's swap Gligar with Vibrava for this next double battle. We should get Vibrava to level up here, which will put us just a level away from evolution. Oh, we missed the sand to him. Be a little bit of a pain in the butt to take down. He's a little resistant. Good flinch. Let's see if we can get a crit. Wise will start chipping away at it. Good paralysis. Oh, it's so fast! I don't think it's gonna go down to the sand tomb. There's a dragon breath again. We'll put up our own sandstorm here. Not that the sandstorm's gonna hurt Skarmory. But it'll hurt what's over on the other side. Good job, Vibrava, on the level up. And the new. And that's the only thing that will take damage from that sandstorm. So let's drop a rock tube there. And we're going to aerial ace into the Lanoon. Us for a bit of damage. Steel Wing ain't hit nothing, Skarmory. Gonna keep going. We'll make sure we hit it. All right, there we go. Rare candy's pretty nice. Probably knows water pulse. Oh, but a mist. Aha! I'm gonna swap over to Claydol. Sharpedo. Go to Nidoqueen. Drop a sledge bomb on that Sharpedo. And down it goes because critical hit. Very nice. Easy peasy. This Claydol is such a tank. Get it, Gligar! Alright, we just got a few trainers left on this route. We're gonna put the sand on this Magikarp. Mainly for this Gyarados coming out next. Oh, go ahead and intimidate us. Good level up. Come down here for the trainer with the two star U's. Gligar's trying to learn Screech, we're gonna pass. We're gonna swap Claydol up. Good damage. We have plenty of repels, so that's not ever going to be a problem. Followed by a star. Still got it with the side beam, so that's good. Not quite enough for a level up. We have Ice Beam, otherwise this Gloom would be a real bad matchup for Swampert. Azumarill. We'll take almost Swampert. I'm looking over here at my tracker, it shows me experience on my Pokemon, and I was trying to decide if I wanted to use Swampert or Claydol. trainer over here. He's got a shift tree and a nose pass. The nose pass should get Claydol up to 44. Good paralysis. Alright, we'll swap over to Dragon Breath. All it's doing is prolonging the fight. Go. We'll do that swimmer on our way back. We want to get this double battle first. Did a pretty good amount, but it was a critical hit. The cool is down. Good deal. Let's get a little experience on Gligar here. And we'll be right back. I'm going to do a quick restroom. And I'm still muted. Alright. Should just be two more fights. There should be a fisherman here. Bailmer will go to Gligar. Ooh, that did a lot of damage. But we didn't get confused. That was the main thing we were looking out for. As long as we survived it, we were fine. Alright, there should be one more trainer around here with a Staryu. Good deal. Alright, let's heal up really quick. We're gonna swap up Nidoqueen. But I always forget I need both Mews. Or I need that other one to know dive and everything and blah blah blah. We're gonna deposit Claydol. Sorry about that. My fault for forgetting. All this way to get this double battle. Oh, he moved! Alright, we're gonna get our evolution from Vibrava into Flygon after this fight, assuming we don't get knocked out for some reason. Sharpedo and Mightyena. Critical hit and good paralysis. There we go. Let's take out this mighty. Swagger on Nidoqueen. Not ideal. Good, got the sludge bomb off. Got a poison too, very nice. So let's just double target down into Golbat. I really don't like this Nidoqueen. And it knocks itself out with the recoil from the takedown. Come on, Nidoqueen. Beautiful. Beautiful. Evolution! We had two moves ready for Flygon. I teach a Hyper Beam. place of Secret Power. And then we're also going to teach it Flamethrower. In place of Rock Tomb. Then we're going to use Pokemon Power Max on Hyper. Alright, so let's read about Flygon before we go on. So Flygon is a Pokemon that resembles a slightly insectoid bipedal dragon. It is primarily light green and has a pair of large rhombus-shaped wings with red trim, toeless hind legs, and skinny arms with three clawed hands. Flygon's tail has several dark green stripes and three small green rhombus shape with red trims at the end. It has large eyes and a pair of green antennae that point back. Its eyes have red covers that prevent sand from getting into them. With its wings, it kicks up sandstorms to hide itself. Its wings make a singing sound when they are flapped, earning Flygon the name the Desert Spirit. It uses this unique ability to attract prey, stranding them before it attacks. Flygon lives in the desert, where it typically works together with Crocodile in searching for food, whipping up sandstorms for Crocodile to hide in as they hunt, and then splitting the prey that they manage to catch. In our Gen 3 Pokedex information for Flygon, Ruby says, Flygon has the nickname the Elemental Spirit of the Desert because its flapping wings whip up a cloud of sand, and this Pokemon has always felt a sandstorm of flying. Sapphire says Flygon whips up a sandstorm by flapping its wings. The wings create a series of notes that sound like singing. Because the singing is the only thing that can be heard in the sandstorm, this Pokemon is said to be the Desert Spirit. Emerald says the flapping of its wings sound like singing. To prevent detection by enemies, it hides itself by flapping up a cloud of desert sand. And Fire Red and Leaf Green say it hides itself by kicking up desert sand with its wings. Red cover shield its eyes from the sea. And that is our information on Flygon, our final evolution. And we do get a really good stat boost to our attack and speed, really around the board for Flygon. So that all is looking good. We're going to swap Nidoqueen up, and we're going to give Nidoqueen a Hyper Potion. Here we get Earthquake. And we're going to teach this to Gligar so it has its ground attack. Teach this in place of Slash. Here comes Archie. Swaggered. Alright, so Archie heals it with a super potion. We do hurt ourselves in the confusion, but then we get off the other sludge bomb, so that's good. That was some major damage there. Crobat is coming out next, and that is speed. We're gonna swap to... Can we swap to Gligar here? Sure. Even if it double teams a bunch, we have Aerial Ace. So we're going to kick up a Sandstorm. We'll raise our evasion a bit. We also have really high defense for like Air Cutter and such. And I would expect that Archie is going to heal it with another hyper or super potion, which he does. This is the wing attack. Bam. This is the Confuse Ray. Wow, that Sandstorm was paying off dividends for Gligar. Hey, not Valerie. I do remember you. Welcome back to the channel. Long time no see. Well, nice. I'm glad that you got home early so you could watch. We're going to be going for another hour after this, so we'll be able to hop through another episode here. Working our way towards Juan and the Cetopolis City Gym. All this talking, blah, blah, blah. They're outside. The weather is horrible. All right, let's go back to Moss Deep. Let's get our Claydol back. Excellent. So this is just a note for myself. We are going to be ending this episode here for YouTube. We're going into another episode. So cut this episode here for YouTube.